beautiful invitation, like that buzzing energy from the earth herself has a hum. And so I want you to express your psychic gifts and your powers in this moment and see if you can attune yourself to the frequency of the earth. And listen to her, since we're being so subtle today. There's quite a gift here. Exhale, send your energy down into the earth. And let's do that two more times. You feel it? I can feel you feel it. This is good. It's juicy, right? Sometimes things that are so subtle and simple can like create the most power. So let's just do five maybe tones and we'll kind of go around in the circle. So deep breath here. So just in that one, I could feel that some of you in this, whoever in this room, in this space, in our collective temple, there's a little bit of fear around being in the earth. There's a little bit of grief as well. Breathe almost beyond it by staying in the neutral space. Okay? A few more rounds.
Oh, yeah.
One more. Calling on the whale consciousness that I see you, I see you, I see you, inviting in the whales, the direction of the west. Deep breath here, medicine, breathe that in. Actually in front of us. And so my prayer in these next couple of rounds is that we can receive wisdom from our tome and receive something about who we are. And then as we anchor that, we're going to move up the chakra system. And I invite you to continue putting in the chat different imagery that comes up for you, different things that you see as you sing. Okay, deep breath.
Ooh.
blockage of control and like a real fear around surrendering and a real fear around like getting present. We'll do one more. Let's see if we can clear it. Deep breath. I'm speaking to others. Imagine the energy underneath us swirling. Here, I can actually, I'll use my microphone. Imagining the energy that is underneath us, that it's swirling in a current of energy. So let's do one more ground. And then on the next one, we're going to pull up. I can feel some of you doing it, pulling up, receiving the prana and the nourishment of the Great Mother, the ocean of her earth inside your being. This is something that I teach in workshops and also to my clients, where it's so important that we have this access to ground, to grounding, to feeling that primal energy of the earth in within us. So important. So one more time, grounding and then pulling the energy all the way up into the body. Deep breath here. Up into yourself, into your energetic body, into your whole being, and as we tone now up the chakras, I invite you to weave all of this juicy energy up to your whole entire being, okay? So here we go. It's going to be so beautiful. And I also hear the Gate mantra wants to be sung. So we're going to weave up the energy now from the earth. So I'm going to go in a different direction, actually. Deep breath here. Tailbone. you have like a grandmother's spirit or a connection to a guide that is ancient feminine energy, I invite you to receive her wisdom, to dance with her here. I feel that presence here of the grandmothers whispering to you in your dreams, guiding you on, and all of the ancient mothers, lineage upon lineage throughout time. Grounding. See how you can, so when I say grounding, you can imagine the energy going into the earth and now pulling up and receiving.
Really rich and juicy.
Losing the connection from the belly, the lower body, in fact, weaving and gathering all of that sustenance, but feeling it in the heart space collectively. And what is your prayer today? What does that mean for you? This chakra, I feel like we're going to do some work here, so let's feel into it together. But this chakra of the anahata means unstruck, so it cannot be damaged. It is our portal and our gateway for compassion. The bodhisattva vow to see other beings, to feel that we are one with them, to want them to raise their consciousness, to be higher beings. In fact, the bodhisattva vow is that we must stay incarnated for all beings everywhere to become enlightened. There is no point, because we are all connected, that if some are suffering and still in the wheel of samsara and suffering, that any of us could escape, because we are all truly one. And so the back of the chakra is also our past, romantically, energetically, and there's a lot of grief that can be here. It's tight sometimes, it's heavy, we're burdened sometimes by our grief or what we carry. And we also have wings on our back. Our ancestors, our guides, our angels, shamanic teachers, helpers, ascended masters, animal totems, the elements, the directions, we can call those in. And on the right side of our body, our paternal lineage of DNA, and on the left side, maternal. And so they stand behind you, and so your wings can be tattered and torn and come in all different shapes and sizes and expressions depending where you are on your journey. And you have also the power to move through intention, to gather that energy down from the earth, all the way into the belly, all the way up, 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 up into the heart, and allow a tone, a gentle, beautiful, beautiful tone to come out through the voice that is the quality of all that you are carrying within your heart now. And it doesn't have to sound beautiful, but I will tell you that the syllable ah or yum, these are tones that feel and fuel that heart chakra. And the bowl is singing on its own now. Do you hear that? That's your heart. Breathe in. Breathe out. Honor it. Honor how beautiful that is, what a gift it is to receive, to hear your own heart sing to you, and let out a sound as the rains fall into the heart now, allowing that to be expressed through the voice, and feel the weaving from all the way from the base of the body, from the earth, all the way up into the heart chakra, all the way up into the throat. And feel that purifying you. One more deep breath. Flutter here. I invite in a sound that will be playful here, right? Anahata. We don't let our inner child play all the time. Sometimes you have to keep everything kind of even, right? And the inner child also wants to play, also wants joy. I feel that here. It's like a yearning. So let's give that gift for a moment, yes? So a flutter would be like, practice a little bit, and you guys can practice different. Like that. You ready? See, the thing is, we get self-conscious, you know? And sometimes the play, it doesn't happen as natural as it can. So embody the fool, you know, the cosmic sacred fool, and then there's no pretense. We can be as goofy and silly as we care. But don't lose connection with the rest of the chakras, ready? So drawing the energy up from the earth through the central column of the body into the heart, and then just... separate that warm and sure stillness from this inner child, but sometimes they are so there. It is me, and it is with a lot of my clients, like they almost feel like rivals sometimes, the wise woman and the inner child. So let's see if we can invite that more serious part to also play in a way that feels good. I'll do it one more time. Anahata. So many beautiful dimensions, you know, this frequency of coherence we can feel out in all of these directions. And as we do this now, let's weave that energy out through the voice. Yeah? Mm-hmm. So we're feeling the grief, but we're going to express it through sound. And that itself is our prayer. Intention and energy and movement creates portals, opens us to the infinite, allows us to call and receive from there, which we'll get to just in a bit. So deep breath here. Express all of those energies, what would it be? Or maybe a lion's breath. Oh, well, I think we've moved into the throat chakra. I'm feeling a lot of constriction here. I can make a joke and say some of you need to work with me. There's a lot of tension here around our full self-expression. Oh, wow, you guys. Okay, I'm going to put the bowl down. I want to do some lion's breaths with you. So we're going to move the energy here in the Vishuddha chakra as purification. Keep the energy up in the heart, but off our low, almost like a purge, like you're... this is where it becomes more like a yoga class. It doesn't have to be pretty. It's just... whoosh. And I do this exercise a lot with my clients too, especially for those of you who have trapped anger. It has to do a whole ritual around not mine, not mine, not mine. And you can say anything that you're carrying, sometimes the back of our neck and the nape of our neck where our neck meets our skull. Not mine. Good. I can feel it. I can feel it. Great. Bring one hand to your heart, one hand to the third eye. See if you can connect these two. Seeing that the voice is in between. Feeling the connection of your intuition now with the heart. And merge your mind in service to the heart. And offer a prayer, a sound through the voice that's in alignment with something that you're desiring, your mind is connected to, but not attached. We don't want to move from that space of the mind. We're pulling it back now, weaving the third eye, third eye, third eye. For those of you who are cocooning, I can feel you. Into the jaw, into the heart, and expressing out through the voice and even through the ajna chakra. So the throat to the ajna. Center of the brow, pituitary, pineal gland, occipital, back of the head. Imagine that whole vibration. In fact, you can, if you know bees breath, we were just talking about this. I was at this ceremony of the bees. There's a vibrational attunement in Kundalini practice where you close your ears, you put your hands on your eyes and your nose and your mouth, and you vibrate the skull and the head and you hum. So you can do that if it feels good to you. And when you hum, I invite you to send the hum through the third eye. It's a deep breath here. Wait, let me find it. System through all the way up through the throat to the third eye. Deep breath here. Send light out the crown of your head. Chakra. And this is a really beautiful gateway. And I can feel it right now. I can feel the light coming in. And so it's open for most of you, which is beautiful. And so as you open and unwind, even more unravel, imagine like a lotus flower at the top of the head. And that there's this beautiful cord of energy, light, all the way goes all the way out into the cosmos to your favorite star, the place you come from that is truly home, and then weaves down, 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 down into you. And this gift, this gateway, this is how we become an instrument and a channel of the divine, a channel truly of something that is higher than ourselves. And I want you to just breathe that in for a moment. It's effortless here. You can receive energy so easily, especially if you're here because you're wired a certain way, if you're listening to me. And so this might be very easy for you, and going down and grounding is the more challenging piece. But this part, your astral connection, your connection to the infinite, that is pure and open. And sometimes the mind will get in the way of it, but all in all, or the tension and the jaw, I can feel some of you are like, oh, it's actually a little scary for me. That's okay. But in this moment, I just invite you to receive these frequencies and these energies, and I'm going to just do some kind of impromptu light language singing feelings as we call in this galactic energy. We call in the rains that are here. We tune ourselves to the field that is nature, that is the all, that is the wonderful beauty of the divine. And then we breathe her in, whatever personification feels appropriate to you. Ceremony, and in these ayahuasca ceremonies you have visions. And in this vision I was met by a being who was, if you had to describe him, he was like a bald man and very thin and almost like a Chinese statue of the fisherman, you know, like a very humble looking man, old man. And he bowed to me next to me and he said to me, "Don't you see that none of us here, so none of the higher beings on the astral plane," he said, "none of us are judging you." And I was thinking of something very particular in my life at this time. It was 4 years before that. I engaged in a relationship I knew I wasn't supposed to say yes to, but there was, my ego really wanted the attention of this man. And wanted him to not give attention. I just wanted the attention. And so, this is about 10 years ago. And so I made a weird decision and I got myself into a power play and I really knew that I messed up. And I held it and I carried it. And I probably still carry it to some aspect. But in the ceremony, this older wise and saying, we, God, the divine, all of the ascended masters, all of your guides, all of them, the healing ones, we are not judging you. There's no judgment coming from us. The condemnation that you're putting on yourself is coming from yourself. And I broke down and I cried, but I couldn't let it go in that moment. I had to beat myself up about it. I don't know if it was a payoff or a power, but even though I was forgiven, and I know that's a very Christian term, but even if I was forgiven, I couldn't release myself from the mind structure around I should know better. And so weaving that into the shame that we have sometimes, what I see is that the best teachers, the most empowered wise women, the most prolific, beautiful souls are the ones who hesitate when they speak. We are the ones who care so much and hold ourselves to such high standards that we are afraid to actually share. Our life. But the only one holding us to those high standards is ourselves. And to be honest, it's holding us back from recognizing the true divine intelligence that we are, which on another level, all is holy, all is love, and only love is real. And it's just what you choose to pay allegiance to tune to feed. What wolf do you nourish? What wolf do you feed? What constructs in your mind do you keep? And so as we are in the sixth chakra now, rewiring the mind away from any shame or perception of wrongdoing, that we could get it wrong. We are here to learn lessons, and we are going through initiations constantly, and there are trials and tribulations and tests and growth. The identity that we shape about ourselves and all of the pain that is interwoven with that, ask now in this moment, in this ceremony, as a leader, for all who are hearing this message at this time, including myself, but all of you, I can feel you, I can see you. If we can collectively offer and lift that up now with our voices, with our tone, with our expression, on this 1111 gateway, may our intention for group and global healing to release any shame or the imprint of shame that we are separate from the divine in any way, in any identity or egoic interweaving, that we let go of that program now. And we offer it as the rains come down and cleanse the soul. We offer it. We offer it. We offer it to you. Take it from us. We do not need it anymore. Into the heart, allowing it to be the medicine that you need.
Thank you.